Happy morning to everyone. In this session, we are going to discuss about Unit 2 Quantum Mechanical Model of Atom. In this lesson, we are going to see about what is atom, what are the models proposed for the atoms. Next, the scientists which are to give the assumption about the atoms. Then, we are going to discuss about what about the quantum mechanical model of the atom given by a Schrödinger. Based on the quantum mechanical of the atom, you have to introduce quantum numbers. What are the quantum numbers? What are the uses of quantum numbers? Otherwise, what the need for quantum numbers? Followed by the quantum numbers, we are going to see about the shape of the atomic orbital. Then, how the electrons are filling in the atomic orbital. If I see these topics, lessons are going to it. Now we'll see what about the introduction to atomic models. Before going to the topic, first we'll see the history of the atom timeline. It's nothing but the scientists who are all to introduce the model of atom. The idea of the atom is an ancient one, initially proposed by Greeks. First, in the atom, in the word, in the atom, the model of first introduced in Greeks, the Greek scientist Democritus in 460 BC. Then, after that, the Dalton, he has given the theory of atom, arise Dalton atomic theory. So, afterwards, in 1897, the Thomson is given the plum pudding electron model. Then followed by the Thomson, in 1912, Rutherford, so based on the proton, he has introduced the model of the atom. So finally, the model of the atom concluded by a Bose. So already studied in the lower sections, what is the Bose atomic theory? The Bose introduced at 1913, what is the model of the atom? So after the Bose model, or based on the Bose model, so many scientists, they are given the final atomic structure based on mechanical or modern quantum theory in 1930. So you will see one by one how the scientists are given the assumption about the atom of the model. So now we discuss what about the history of the atomic theory. In first, Democritus, 460 BC, he given the structure of atom or model of the atom. Then in 1803, Dalton, he proposed atom is a solid particle. Then in 1897, Thomson, he has to given the structure of atom based on the electron. Then in 1909, Rutherford is given the model of the atom based on the discovery of proton. Afterwards, in 1913, finally, the Bose, he has to introduce electron orbital nucleus. Based on the electron orbital nucleus, is given the model of the atom. So this is your final atom. Afterwards, a discovery of in 1935, Chadwick, he discovered the neutron. Finally, nowadays we are following the atomic structure based on the quantum atomic theory or quantum atom theory proposed by Schrödinger and some other scientists also. Now we'll see one by one what is the model of the atom, how they are proposed or how they are given the assumption about the model of the atom. First, in 400 BC or 460 BC, the Democritus is introduced the word of atom. The word of atom is nothing but is a indivisible. The word is nothing but indivisible particle. Democritus is a one of the great Greek philosopher. He only introduced the word of atom. The word of atom can be derived from the Greek word atomos. Atomos is nothing but indivisible or indivisible particle. So for this atom, there is any experimental proof for that. Here, the Democritus, he proposed the atom does not contain any protons or electrons or neutrons, is a solid particle. And also it will be an indestructible or indivisible particle. Followed by the Democritus, in 1803, John Dalton, he proposed a theory of atom or atomic theory. John Dalton is an English school teacher and also is one of the chemists. He studied the results of experiment by many other scientists. So based on the other many other scientists, he is given the what about the atomic theory. Now what about the Dalton atomic theory? The first one, all matter is made up of tiny individual particles called atoms. Atom of the same element are identical. Those of different atoms are different. Atom of different elements combine in whole number ratio to form compounds. For example, water molecule. There are two hydrogen combined with one oxygen. It has gives the 2:1 ratio of hydrogen to oxygen gives the water molecule. The fourth one, the chemical reaction involves the arrangements of atoms. No new atoms are created or destroyed. ஒரு ஆட்டத்தை நம்மளால் உருவாக்க முடியாது, அதே மாதிரி அழிக்கவும் முடியாது. ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் தீஸ் அசம்ஷன்ஸ் ஆர் கிவன் பை டால்டன். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் டால்டன் அட்டாமிக் தியரி. ஸோ திஸ் ஆல்சோ வெரி சக்சஸ்ஃபுல் வென் ஆட்டம் வாஸ் கன்சிடர்ஸ் ஏ நான் டிவைசபிள் அன்டில் த டிஸ்கவரி ஆஃப் சப் அட்டாமிக் பார்ட்டிகல் சச் எஸ் எலக்ட்ரான், புரோட்டான் அண்ட் நியூட்ரான். ஸோ தென் ஒன்லி த சயின்டிஸ்ட் தே ஆர் ட்ரை டு ப்ரூவ் த அட்டாமிக் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் பை ஏ வேரியஸ் மெத்தட். Then, in 1897, Thomson used to propose a model of atom based on the cathode ray experiment. So, by a cathode ray experiment, J.J. Thomson used to discover electrons. So, based on the electron, he used to propose what is the model of the atom. Now, we say, by a cathode ray experiment, he discovered electron. So, based on the electron, he proposed plum-pudding model. What is the plum-pudding model? Like a water melon. So based on that, it given the assumption atom made up of positive charged mass, electron scattered throughout the mass. It has to fail to explain what is the correct structure of atom. In other words, J.J. Thomson, he proposed the atom is a positive charged sphere in which the electrons are embedded like the seeds in the water plant. ஒரு வாட்டர் பிளான்ல அது சீட்ஸ்ல எப்படி இருந்து புதஞ்சிருக்குமோ அந்த மாதிரி ஒரு ஆட்டம் இஸ் ஏ சாலிட் ஸ்பியர். இன் டு த சாலிட் ஸ்பியர் எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் கேன் பி எம்பெடட். லேட்டர் த ரூதர்ஃபோர்ட் ஆல்ஃபா ரே ஸ்கேட்டரிங் எக்ஸ்பெரிமெண்ட் ரிசல்ட்ஸ் ப்ரூவ் தட் த தாம்சன் மாடல் வாஸ் ராங். ஸோ வி நோ தட் நவ் ஒன்லி யூ சேட் யூ கேன் நாட் பி ப்ரப்போஸ் ஏ ப்ராப்பர் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் ஆஃப் கரெக்ட் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் ஆஃப் த ஆட்டம். ஓகே, தென் ஆஃப்டர் டிஸ்கவரி ஆஃப் த புரோட்டான் பை ஏ ஆல்ஃபா ரே ஸ்கேட்டரிங் எக்ஸ்பெரிமெண்ட் த தாம்சன் மாடல் வாஸ் ராங். ஃபார் தட் they introduced Rutherford model of atom. In 1909, Ernst Rutherford, he proposed the atomic model based on alpha ray experiment. So what is alpha ray? Alpha is nothing but helium molecule or helium particle. Here, the helium molecule or the helium particle can bombard to the thin gold foil. Based on the experiment, he has to given what about the assumption for the atomic structure of the atom. Here the thin gold, here we are using alpha ray. Because of the alpha ray, it contains two protons. When it bombard to the thin gold foil, it just shows some observation. Otherwise, it just shows some results. Based on the results, he proposed what about the model of atom. Now he said the alpha particles can bombard to the thin gold foil. Around the gold foil, you have to place the recorders. What are the detectors or recorder? So after the bombarding of alpha particle in thin gold foil, he observed the three rays. One is the A, B, C. The first one A is a transmitted lights or transmitted rays. There is no any deflection. In second one B, in that B, it also shows or it has to produce a scattered beam with a small deflection. In the third case, he has observed the third ray that also scattered beam, but it has a large deflections. So based on the three rays, one is a transmitted, second one is a scattered with a small deflection, third one scattered with a large deflection. So based on that, he has to observe three things as follows. The first one, the A, transmitted light. Most of the alpha particles pass through the thin gold foil, that's why it has to transmitted. The second one B, so the scattered with a small deflection. So from that, you assume one thing, some of them are deflected through a small angle. It also deflected with a small angle. The third one, very few alpha particles were deflected back by a 180 degree angles. So the A, it will be direct away, it has to transmitted. The B, it will be dashed to deflected or it has scattered by a small deflection. The third one, the C, very few alpha particles were reflected back by a 180 degree angle. Based on these observations, Rutherford concluded that the atom is mostly empty space. However, the atom contains a nucleus where the mass and the positive charge of the atom are concerned. We now know that the nucleus contains protons and neutrons. But the electrons orbit the nucleus but are not part of it. In other words, the Rutherford nuclear model, atom is composed of tiny nucleus and orbiting electrons. Most of the atom is empty space. Very small electron occupy most of the space. Finally, the nucleus is composed of protons and neutrons. என்ன சொல்ல வராங்கனாக்கா, ஆட்டம்ஸ் எல்லாமே எதா கம்போஸ் பண்ணியிருக்கும், நியூக்ளியஸும் எலக்ட்ரான்ஸும் கம்போஸ் பண்ணியிருக்கும். அதே அந்த ஆட்டம்ஸில் வி ஹவ் த லாட் ஆஃப் எம்டி ஸ்பேஸ். இன்டு த லாட் ஆஃப் எம்டி ஸ்பேஸ் த ஸ்மால் எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் கேன் பி ஆக்குபைட் த ஸ்மால் ஸ்பேஸ். நியூக்ளியஸ் ஆர் கம்போஸ் பை ஏ ப்ரோட்டான்ஸ் அண்ட் நியூட்ரான்ஸ். ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் அப்சர்வ் பை ரூத்ரஃபோர்ட் இன் ஆல்ஃபா ரே ஸ்கேட்டரிங் எக்ஸ்பெரிமெண்ட். Based on that, it gave the logical proof for the structure of atom. And also, it fails to explain the real world observation about the atom system. So, the Rutherford model has some limitation. The first one, an electron accelerating around the nucleus would continuously emit electromagnetic radiation and loss energy. Therefore, it would eventually fall into the nucleus and the atom would collapse. However, this is not consistent with the real world observations. Atoms are stable. சரி, என்ன சொல்லணும்னாக்கா, ஒரு ஆட்டம் ஒரு ஆர்பிட்ல கண்டினியூஸா ரிவால்வ் ஆகிட்டு இருக்கும்போது இட் ஹஸ் டு எமிட் சம் ரேடியேஷன், இட் ஹஸ் டு லாஸ் த எனர்ஜி. அட் எ சர்டன் பாயிண்ட் வென் இட் லாஸ் த எனர்ஜி, இட் ஈஸிலி கொலாப்ஸ் இன்டு த ஆர் இட் ஈஸிலி பி கொலாப்ஸ் இன்டு த நியூக்ளியஸ். ஸோ த ஆட்டம்ஸ் த வாட் அபவுட் த ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் வில் பி கொலாப்ஸ். So the atom will be unstable, but in real world they are observed, the atoms are very stable. So this is the main limitation of Rutherford model. In other words, the Rutherford model cannot be explain the stability of an atom. The model does not explain the distribution of electrons around the nucleus and their energies. So now we are concluded, now we are summarized what the limitation of Rutherford model. The Rutherford model cannot be explained the stability of the atom. ஏன்னா நம்ம சொன்ன மாதிரி தான், எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் வந்து ஆர்பிட்டல் ரிவால்வ் ஆகிட்டு இருக்கும்போது இட் எமிட் சம் ரேடியேஷன், ரேடியேஷன் கொடுக்கறதால இட் ஹஸ் லாஸ் த எனர்ஜி. ஸோ இட் இட் வில் பி கொலைடிங் த நியூக்ளியஸ். ஸோ த ஸ்டேபிள் த ஆட்டம் வில் பி ஸ்டேபிள், பட் பேசிக்கலி த ஆட்டம்ஸ் ஆர் மோஸ்ட் ஸ்டேபிள். த செகண்ட் ஒன், ஸோ ஹவு த எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் ஆர் கேன் பி ரிவால்வ் அரவுண்ட் த நியூக்ளியஸ், வாட் அபவுட் த எனர்ஜி லெவல்ஸ். ஓகே, த ஃபஸ்ட் செகண்ட் தேர்ட் லைக் தட். ஸோ எனர்ஜி லெவல்ஸ், ஸோ it to fail to explain the stability of the atom and the distribution of electron around the nucleus and the energies. So that's all about the Rutherford atomic model. So in this video we discuss what about the introduction of atomic model, what are the model can be proposed for the atom. Into that we have discussed what about the Democritus model, what about the Dalton atomic theory. The third one was the J.J. Thomson theory. Finally, we discuss what about the Rutherford atomic model. So, next video, we are going to see about what about the Bohr's atomic model. Then, what about the quantum mechanical model of the atom. So, we'll see you next class. Thank you.